almost like to say that he recognized that balance, as I heard Brother Amir had mentioned, and also the eyes, Sister Suleiman Weed had mentioned, not only the divinity and humanity of His Majesty, but because of that faith, right, the faith in spirit and in truth and word and in deed of Her Majesty, she also is expressive and is an expression of that living divinity, you know what I mean, in reality that we can perceive, that's not all spooked out or all flipped out of false fake gods and goddesses of the world, which are just figments of people's imagination. But when we look at the true living man and even woman, we see His word, you understand, in manifestation, you know what I mean? We can approximate that, because it shows us that, well, they are like I and we. You know what I mean? So it gives us a higher height, you know, to aspire for.
Yes,
and spirit. Oh.
And,
oh,
and,
I have
you. Yes, I. And Brother Alonso did point out something that you're pointing out earlier, and I don't know if I can elaborate thoroughly, but that seed of Christ in Deborah, the birth of that, you know, this, that leadership. He talked
about
a lot, and he's right here.
He's
right here.
I'll
let him express.
Yeah.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Yeah,
I think Sister Trinch is trying to bring. She's been trying to get me on for a while.
Yes, sir.
You know, so that's basically what I think is very important. I mean, might as well go in a little bit into it, but I think it's really significant to realize that we all have to first be women. And anyways, I mean, if the man be the head of the women, the woman is the one that get the benefit, because we live because of Christ, you know, and we're His woman. So be, you know, male or female, created He us. So it really don't matter. Christ is that head. And I think that's what the sister is talking about, that seed. But that seed doesn't have to really begin in Christ. It's a faith. And it's a faith. You step into a higher sense of being. You step into Christ walk, you know. And eventually, well, God called whoever He called to do whatever it is that they got to do. So, you know, we all manifest that faith differently, but it's inside of all of us.
Well, could you explain a little bit about the man also taking that role and being comfortable in that? You had really elaborated that on such a level on how, like, the flip and flip, like, you know, he was able to say, okay, you know, like Godin was explaining.
Well, it doesn't really come down to, like, male or female. It's Christ. Christ is the way. So that we see Deborah, we see acting in a more well-rounded Christ misali, or, like, example. And so we see Barak coming to her kind of, like, indecisive in that I'm going to go to the leader, the leader that's being led by the ruler, which is Christ. That's in one mind with the Father, so there's no contradiction. It'd be what it'd be. But the need to subject ourselves and all things to Christ. It's not a title thing. Oh, I'm a man, so I rule. No, you set the example, but you know, Genesis 3:15, it goes, I think it's 3:15, it goes into, like, that in much sorrow than the woman shall conceive. I don't know, but I think sorrow is multiplied greatly through multiplied great sorrow, you know, the woman shall conceive. So to whom more is given, I give you more, Rabbah. You know, kind of think that's the word being used. Require greatly. So whoever it see the beginning of creation in to us, at least it must begin female, because we all got to manifest as a virgin, being free from foreign thoughts and open to the miraculous conception. We got to begin feminine, be susceptible, be that ground in which that seed can sprout. So now having let's go forward to the like multiplying, and so be it male or female, to whomever it's been given more is required of them to exercise that faith and exploit the hope, so that all can endure the hardness and be what needs be done through us, you know, by following the only true head of whatever the circumstance, situation, scenario be, which
yes,
is Christ, Yahweh HaMashiach. And so, kind of, like, what was he talking about?
Yes, I
am. No, I'm
sorry.
Well, the need to realize that creation begins neutral, but it's female and it's in its right sense. And from much being given, much is required, and so we break, you know, we break the matrix with that which contradicts the rule, which is a preconceived notion of what is even not. And so you know, you kind of enter into the faith growth process, which is love. If, just being what you need to be. If I'm a 29-year-old male and my little niece need a 12-year-old best girlfriend, then that's what in Christ I shall be, you know. If she need a parent, a strict male parent for a, you know, the scenario, you know, relative, wisely comparing itself to the relation,
uh-huh.
I mean to the circumstance, then that's what I shall be.
I am.
You know, kind of.
Yes, I am.
Amen.
So Paul says, 1 Corinthians, and the reason I and I is going into this is because people need to realize that we must begin to see things like from within. So when I read, like,
yes, you know,
I'm not thinking like, oh, I rule over a woman. I said, well, the beginning of creation is female, then it must be logically governed in that rightful love, which is Christ. So I'm not going to see anything outside of myself, because then I'm going to reflect like negativity. I'm not going to walk into the tree of knowledge of good and evil. See, when I begin to look within myself, I see guilt, and I see all the things that I do not want to be charged upon me. So whenever I see outside of myself, I'm going to see the good things of life that people bring. But I want people.
Hallelujah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, knowing that I myself fall short, it's like I best see the good, you know, hoping that the good be seen in me and we could grow forward.
Yes, I.
But going forward to 1 Corinthians chapter, I can't remember the chapter. It's in the reading, but I think from verse 1 to 5, and Paul begins saying, be ye imitators of I, as I am of Christ, you know, so keeping that. So he's giving an example of like compassion, like, all right, don't take this the wrong way, women and men. You know, being Christ, I follow me because I follow Christ. You know, like Christ is His Majesty, and His Majesty is in the Christ. You know, so the Majesty of Christ and His kingly character now revealed. You know, to I and I, and we too shall be as bees. You know, if there's desert land, it's because we ain't pollinating.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
Hey.
We shall. You know, that's kind of interesting. Let me throw in the bar. You know, the bar. In Spanish, is interesting because deber is kind of like saying you owe, but it isn't necessarily like in a negative sense. It's your duty.
Mm-hmm.
You must go and pollinate. You know, and that's what bees are good at.
Debe hacerlo.
Do what they do. And there's the queen bee. You know. What's it called? Everyone else
works. Worker bees.
We do what we have to do. Ain't no strife. If we got to defend the hive, then we do. But we don't go out stinging just for fun, because then we lose part of ourselves and then we die. You know, I've heard.
Right.
I'm not sure if it's accurate, but according to prior knowledge, it says that, and I can't reference where I heard this. Yeah, the bee loses its part of the stinger. It stays on you, and it passes on.
Uh-huh.
So we ain't.
Yes, I.
We got that security in and through Yeshua HaMashiach, so that we won't.
Hallelujah.
Eating for fun, you know. But anyway, it's like the owing. It's our duty, and it's our duty to provide for the queen provides for us. Now, the male, you know, it's there. The alpha male has already confirmed that, yeah, the sun is the way, you know, so be as the sun and serve the hive. Pollinate and spread the word, you know. Spread love, deber, and help forward to the bar. So the word is a commitment. You speak a word, so it's you spoke it. You said it, so you owe it. You must, you know. So we've been, you know, written into this life story, and now we be the word. So it's the covenant. It's what we must do, and we must love one another. So, you know, which is the ultimate word, because love breaks the spell. It goes against logic.
Yes, I...
The set norm. And Pharaoh ain't having that, but we bringing it. So, you know, so, like, love, it contradicts what else would be kind of, like, foolish. Like, for example, people talk about their gods and their need to satisfy their gods with offerings every single day. And I come forward and we say, well, our God, being God, lived as man and served us to the highest degree, because to him much more and much more was required. So he in turn served us. So it's perfect equality. And people might be interested in a God like that, because that's kind of weird. That, what do you mean? You know, God being God, he's a man. So what do you say? You know, it kind of like puts Pharaoh in a position where he's got to really contemplate what's really going on. But, I mean, that's... Now, the love, the word is the love, but the word transmitted through the Holy Spirit in whatever way it needs or must be transmitted. See, and Joseph is very much a part of this. You know, the bones were mentioned, the structure which holds his flesh together, which is, in a way, it's expressing Eve as it is Adam, but more so Christ. So I do know that that's in the beginning of the Shabbat study that we're talking about right now. So Joseph, what was Joseph? He was the one that was sent to gather his children. So go speak to them. Go love them. Do whatever you got to do. Yeah, do whatever you must do. I know it's you that can do it, but make sure you bring them back together and safe. You know, and what do you go do to them? Well, he sought to go speak the word, to communicate in love the necessity to come together, that our Father not perish in our division, you know. So
give thanks for that. I'm sorry, I didn't want to really interrupt. This is Sister Aisha, and just what you're saying really is ringing a bell with me. Through the week, I, you know, trying to read the Word and study, and the Spirit led me to Thessalonians, and it just goes exactly with what you're saying about the Word and being His Word and doing our duty, and, you know, the discipleship, and just in our faith, our duty. And so, as I think it's Thessalonians chapter 2, if I could read, it's chapter 2, verse 4, it says, but as we were allowed of Elohim to put trust, to be put in trust with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but Elohim, which trieth our hearts. And that whole chapter just kind of really goes into that about speaking and studying the Word and being the Word, just as an example. So it kind of just, you know, it kind of just goes off of what you're saying, Brother Alonzo.
Well, yes, let me just we give thanks and praises to John Christ for that. The love.
Yes,
the love.
That's
the example. Be ye imitators of I as I am in Christ, because Christ is the proverb, the example, the exemplary character that all men everywhere must do their best. You know, that good example as best as we possibly can, you know. And if we happen to make mistakes and we do err, then we as Christians, Ethiopian, Hebrew, Rastafari, we know that we have the chance, the possibility of forgiveness from the Almighty, you know. So grace, mercy be shown to all, but the love to whom more is given, of them more is required. So deber, it's our dabar. Our word is to keep. We must keep it and guard it, for that's what's been given to us. Things concealed belong to Jah, but he reveals it to his own, and it's for us to transmit to the oncoming generation all the time. and so now, the bar, so that's the word, our must. We must do it. And it's not a heavy must. It's a very light yoke that we should be thankful that we've been given the opportunity to live. And now, knowing how bad we've lived, then we, you know, it's our must, it's our word sound to make all else through that word and spread that mercy. Now, spate amar, I know that in the Hebrew, the root to go to see, saying like speak or spake is through love. I got a little bit carried away. I went forward. No, it's amar. Now, using that word in the Hebrew, amar, relating it to speak or spake, I'd like to share or add to that the Spanish definition of what amar is, and that's to love. Amor is love in general. Amar is to love. So that's the word that we speak. That's our duty to love, because certain things have been revealed to us. Now, if you can overstand a circumstance, that means you're equipped and well prepared to overcome it. Now, it may not be, in most cases, it's not the same for all out. Some people are outside of the scenario, and that means that they're not equipped to grow from that level. And so it's us that prepare the way and not create stumbling blocks for other people, but lay those stones out that they may be, you know, steps to a higher way of living. And so if we could see something, and it's going to take sacrifice on our behalf to maybe keep quiet, maybe to not push the conversation any further, because then it's going to result in argument. Maybe if it's doing something that is uncomforts I, but will prevent like calamity and stuff like that, then it's our duty. Basically, do what we got to do, and job reveals in every moment, every second, our duty of how we can become bigger and better than we have ever been. And so, you know, forming part of a new human race, you know, owing our ultimate allegiance to our fellows within the human community that we have been placed above in the sense, at least in clarity in the spiritual things, but because of that same doing, then we must become servants of those that have been given to our hands, and we help and aid them through communicating love, and that's being higher than the circumstance, overcoming the circumstance, and guiding others to feed, receive, and grow in that same example of being in the Christ head, male or female, expressing that love, loving, amar. And so, you can bring back the children. Job would not that any get perished. So anyways, we must be like willing to like presumir. I don't know how you even say that. Like be conceited, show off our good hope in taking a blow, but for the ultimate good. Anyways, in Christ we know that although it may take time, you know, a good cause will, with faith, courage, and a good cause, just cause, you know, David still beat Goliath. And so we go on forward, you know. I'm kind of just ranting right about now, so I'm going to... I wanted to stick to the Torah part shot, but I kind of went off a little bit.
It was beautiful, brother.
Yeah, and it's the need to exalt Christ above all things, because even as man, you know, one of the very first difficulties I came across was that I never really cared for any of the gods or anything like that, and religion, you know, so I was always kind of like anti-Christ even. I'd talk smack about Christ all day because I wasn't hearing it. So when I saw his majesty and stuff like that, who's that? That's God. Why? Faithful. All right. It's better than anything I know this world can provide. In a very innocent way, because I didn't know enough to even critique.
Right.
You know? But something just told me that it ain't right. Anyways, so going forward with that. One of the first things that I kind of started getting was that, wait a minute, it seems like his majesty wants me to have faith in Christ. What has he got to do with this, you know? But you know what? That's what he said. So I went out. I was in my lunch break. I went out to a Dollar Tree store or whatever. I bought a dollar Bible. And it's funny because first page it said Ethiopia. And then I was like, oh, I know there's this one other verse that kind of relates to Rastafari. I go to Revelation and it says, behold, the conquering, no, the lion of the tribe of Judah, root of David, hath prevailed. I'm all like, oh, it's done. This is what it is. I'm like, brother Rasai Adonis was completely right. You know, so like, That just sealed the deal. But what I was trying to say is that even God the Father, it confirmed that Christ is the way. So to exalt, subjected all things. It wasn't really Christ that subjected all things under him, because all things weren't yet fulfilled until his majesty fulfilled them. So not all things are created until they're created and made manifest. And even then, it's only a story, so it must be made manifest in each and every one of us. So
Christ, hallelujah.
Christ must be resurrected in I and I. Part of the book of life. Otherwise, it's just a story people pass down to you. It may not be real for you. I mean, it could be in theory, but even God himself can testify to the fact. If I go up before him and I tell him, well, what do you know? You ain't never been human, or you don't know what it's like to be man. Yeah, dude. So it's not
right.
Yeah, the Holy Spirit, it can brag on that. It could be like, no, you're wrong. I have been a man, and because I have been, I have all right to say that this isn't just me teaching theory. This is real. I've lived it. And so, I must take our part and really receive it in such a sense. So just like we're to breathe life, give the breath of life and breathe life into that very word, manifesting it through I and I, then so we must manifest that good love, that exemplary character that Jesus Christos has already showed us, through which reason now we can have a fighting chance to actually love, or continue learning of what exactly love is, being it all things and superior to all things, and Christ manifesting that reality to I and I. So we in turn must love, and not just any kind of love, but the love that he himself has showed Ida. And so it's very much a part of this. Everything's female, everything's male, but first and foremost, everything's Christ, and in Christ is the proper order of how we all can overcome the difficulty. So first looking within, coming from that perspective, I kind of went off on another rant, but yeah, I'll pause right here. Give thanks.
All right.
Ghana.
Give thanks.
Yes, I am.
A ti mismito.
We're so grateful, Brother Alonzo, for your reason, man, and adding to the Woman's Wednesdays, Miss Ghana, and we look forward to more reasonments with the eye, and give thanks.
Yes, I give thanks to my brethren. I've been blessed here with, he's really a good anchor and a good Barak, brother. You know what I mean? And just blessed.
Definitely.
More, he's really he walks it out, but he doesn't talk about it. He's on it. He lives it. Preaches day and night, because of his love for Christ, so a living testimony on if we open our mouth and show one, simple as that, the Holy Spirit will
but walk it as well. Yes, I just wanted to say we're down to the last few minutes, and if we